Hey guys, what's going on? Rexdale right here, and today I got a DIY video showing my adjustable kayak shade system. I've seen a few DIYs on forums. The main difference with this, again, is it's adjustable. So you can turn it left and right, and also you can push it up and then down. That way you can really get shade exactly where you need it, no matter where or what direction your kayak is facing. You can fold it down. All right, so let me just do a quick walkthrough. I'll start at the bottom. This is anchored in. It's anchored into the flush mount rod holders. So you'll see here, I'm using a 1/1/4 PVC pipe, and this is a 45 degree elbow to kind of push it back and point it in the right direction to compensate for the angle that the rod holders are in. Then it goes up to a T, and then I have a support PVC pipe here to kind of maintain the structure. You'll see that I opted to kind of just drill these things in instead of using a PVC adhesive, mainly because you really are going to need to adjust this once it's in. And from my experience, the PVC glue doesn't give you a lot of working time to kind of adjust or set it. Here, I just drilled 1/1/4 inch holes all the way through, and I use pins to secure them, and that allows me to break this down so it doesn't go all the way up during transport. Up here, I've got another T. This T is a 1 1/4 to 3/4. So I put this here to control the amount of friction. This is just something new I added based on my experience with it yesterday. With this pivot tilt mechanism, you're gonna really need to make sure it's tight. There's a right balance between, you know, how tight or loose you want it. I put this here to ensure that it's tight enough and it doesn't spread anymore. And then again, I put pins here so I could easily take the top off if I need to. All right, then it goes to an elbow. So let's talk about the main thing here. The main thing here is this is a 1 1/4, and it goes to a bushing. And a bushing pretty much connects two different size pipes. So this goes from a 1 1/4 to a 2-inch. And the 2-inch bushing connects into a 2-inch T-head. So you see, I didn't screw these in. I did leave a hole in case I wanted to screw them in, but I wanted to make this actually move a little bit better. What you want to do is actually make this hard to adjust. That way, the wind doesn't just flap it around. So the pivot point is actually from the bushing to the T, and also from the 1 1/4 pipe in this elbow. So it has two ways to pivot. up here, I used a 3/4 pipe again, because up here I use 1.5 inches, and I felt the 1.5 inches was good and lightweight for the top, but I wanted it to be a little bit stronger. That's why I went 3 1/4 for the centerpiece here. This 3/4 pipe goes into another bushing, which is 3/4 to 2-inch. Now let me take this off real quick. The shade top here is pretty simple. I've got this crossbar here, and then that's a T, elbow. So you can actually make this to whatever size you want. Now, let me show you this kind of helicopter style pivot that I'm working with here. Now, you'll see that again, this is a 3/4 bushing that connects to a 2-inch. Now, in these bushings, there's normally a lip that prevents this pipe from going all the way through. I went ahead and shaved that down so I could push the pipe all the way through so it's more secure. And then I put in a screw here so that this thing doesn't come out of the bushing. And once I'm all done with this build, I'm gonna actually screw in this bushing into this T. That way, the main swivel point is gonna be at that 3/4 pipe. And the shade top doesn't fly away on me. All right, now the reason I put in these pins right here is because I also built another top which I can use for night fishing. And when you're fishing at night, and you're also recording videos at night, you really need to have some kind of light source. So what I did is I wanted an overhead light source. So I just take this piece off. I put this piece on. You'll see I'm using a rubber mallet. But what I'm actually gonna do here, which I started on, is I'm actually gonna grind this down so that it kind of pops in and out of this frame easier. Now, using these same pins, which I put on the opposite side as the shade top, I can secure these as well, using the same pipe. And you'll see here, I'm using the same mechanics as the kayak top, so I can tilt this however I want to, and I could push it left or right. I usually mount my camera right on this spotlight. The spotlight is a Cyclops LED rechargeable light. I picked it up from Academy. It has two settings, so it has a low setting, but then it has a high setting. So I usually use a low setting so I can just have some light on the deck at night. And then I switch it to high setting if I want to kind of beam out in front of me, or if I'm trying to check out what's going on out there, I'll just put it on a high beam. So the way I attach this so it doesn't flop around, again, this is a 2-inch T, and then this spotlight handle fits perfectly into an inch and a half. So I've got this in an inch and a half coupling, and then I added some Velcro so it's a more tighter fit into this 2-inch T. So it fits perfectly like that. All right, so this whole frame system is kind of dual purpose. Now, depending on the kind of kayak you have, you're gonna have to just, you know, figure out your right dimensions, your right lengths. And the main thing that's important if you're gonna try and replicate this build is this T mechanism. You're probably gonna use a 1 1/4. And you may not need this extra support beam here, but you're gonna definitely need this one really close to that main, the main access point, to make sure it doesn't become looser than you need it to be. All right, guys, if you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I'll be doing a more detailed blog post on it on ilivelive.com. You guys can check it out there. And don't forget to subscribe. It's freaking hot, man. Hey, V. V. Can you give me some water? V. All right, you're busy. Why are you so useless? You're fired. That's it. Fired, 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 fired. Everybody's fired. Everybody go home. I'll get my own water.